So, what do you think of my new Spidey suit? Yeah, me and Iron Man built it. Watch out, world. Here comes Spider-Man.
We'll finish Steppenwolf. This city is under my protection.
That's so bad.
I'm Batman.
Ocean 7-Eleven.
Ocean 7-Eleven. That's what it should be called.
Yeah, I like that.
It's good.
I thought it was very. I think, just by discussions. I think I liked it probably the most. It seems
okay.
Yeah, I mean, I liked it. I liked a lot of the things about it. I mean, I had some issues with it just because I thought it was like paced really poorly.
I agree with that.
And I was like, is it still going?
Yeah.
I was like, are we going or is it ending? Is this like the wrap up where you show what everybody's doing? And then it just kept going back to the characters. I'm like, all right, wait. So like, this isn't the end of the movie.
Well, for me at a certain point, it got so ridiculous that I was like, okay, this isn't even an ending. This is
right.
Like, there's still a lot. There's still a point.
Right.
To this.
And I got to that point too. And I was like, all right, they're doing the post stuff. And then I was like, oh, okay, it's still going.
I would have been personally completely content if it just like fade to black right when he tears the list down. You remember?
That would have been cool.
By the way, we're doing full spoilers. Yeah. Blah blah blah. Whatever.
Acting. I thought everybody did a great job except for Hilary Swank.
Yeah,
because she's walking around like the Dark Knight in there.
Yeah,
I was like, that's not how you talk.
I made the same exact joke when you were
in the bathroom.
Oh, really? That was really weird. I didn't like that.
She just sounded to me. She didn't sound like the Dark Knight. To me, she sounded like an evil genius. You know,
she just sounded like
I'm going to find them.
I thought was like trying really hard to like maybe it was supposed to be kind of comical, but it seemed like she was trying hard to like be like. Like badass or like
I know I didn't you know? I didn't think it was comical. I just felt like it was really weird, and it felt really weird, and I felt really like awkward watching her. And I was like, God, get her out of here!
Yeah.
When I heard her voice at the last scene, I was she's back.
No, I said earlier I called out Adam Driver as I thought that he was pretty funny.
Yeah.
I feel like that has they had to have seen Inside Llewyn Davis and seen him playing Al Cody with his like, you know, southern accent, and like he probably says maybe under 100 words in that movie, but anytime he opens his mouth it's hilarious, right? So I feel like they saw that movie and they're like, all right, let's give this man a southern accent in the movie. I feel like he did a great job, and Channing Tatum also did a great job, even though I felt like there was a strange kind of disconnect in the middle there where like he wasn't really in it that much, and they didn't really develop the people around him, as in like his family, as much. And when I say family, I mean like his ex-wife and you know his daughter
and his sister, you know? I guess, right?
I mean his sister was fine. Like, well, she was in it more than his ex-wife was.
Yeah,
she was, you know, so I felt like I had a better sense of who she was.
Yeah. But, oh yeah, when I saw her, I was like, oh god.
Yeah.
But, I don't know. I thought that the movie was paced a little strangely. I'll give you that. But at the same time, I don't know. I thought it had a big charm factor. Mm. The movie itself. The characters, I don't know. They were all pretty much likable.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Other than Hilary Swank.
Yeah.
And I mean, she's a very minor character.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Big deal.
I think everybody's likable when you have really great dialogue.
Mm-hmm.
And you give it a southern accent.
I think Steven Soderbergh definitely does well with creating just like movies that have charm. You know,
he also is good at creating movies with heists.
Apparently,
I feel like he really just wants to perform a heist, and this is just like his outlet. You know what I mean?
I think that he probably already has at this point. You know, but given how well planned out all the heists in these movies are,
we would have no fucking clue.
Because he did that same thing, like you said, he did that same thing in this movie that he did in like Ocean's 11, where he did like the scene at the end that shows what really happened in the heist. That you didn't see.
Yeah.
You know, I was like, oh, he's doing an Ocean's 11 thing.
know? Yeah, yeah.
But, no, that's cool.
Which I thought was cool because it did, like, the heist ended on that kind of weird question mark.
I was like, what? Yeah.
It's like, what is he doing? Yeah. And then it was obvious to me as the, like, ending, like, wrapping things up post was getting longer and longer. I was like, they're going to explain why he, he left the money there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they did.
Daniel Craig and his two brothers were great.
They were.
The brothers were great, and Daniel Craig was, he was,
Daniel Craig was...
something special.
He
was something special.
Yes. Daniel Craig, I feel like he, every time he was in the scene, he was the center of, because he was like, they introduced him in this way that he was supposed, I think, kind of supposed to be scary, or like, you know, that he was like a convict, and then
I feel like they introduced him like he was a bit of a eccentric character in the way that, like, he put his leg up on the table and pulled out the salt shaker
to
shake his eggs, and he knew the exact number that the eggs were in the machine,
like,
you know,
seven, and he had like that, like, it wasn't even like real salt, it was like the fake salt.
Oh, and I don't know if you guys caught it, but his brothers had already bought him a pack of eggs.
I thought that. No, I loved when he said, it's not a bomb, they're not explosives, that's the Joe Bang. Yeah, I thought that was funny, too, because you have, like, I love whenever they try to add, like, a, you know, more a softer side to a criminal like that.
Yeah.
Right?
They did that pretty regularly to him throughout the movie.
Like he's still a criminal, but he's just, like, goofy as hell, and he's, like, carrying this name, Joe Bang.
With Joe Bang.
For whatever reason.
And, like, I just like that him hitting on Melly wasn't, like, super creepy, weird thing.
Yeah.
He just did it, and then he ended up, like, hitting on her some more later.
Yeah. No, it's funny. I have one issue with like the movie at large is that they just kept introducing characters and they never really stopped, as evidenced by fucking Hillary Swank coming in the third act.
Yeah, I know. I was like,
there were a lot of characters in it and a lot of people to kind of, like, a lot of faces to keep up with.
That girl in the traveling doctors thing. She shouldn't have been in the movie at all.
The
that entire scene out.
That scene was so long. Like, they could have cut probably half an hour from this movie. They could have cut, I think, the entire thing with Hilary Swank. Because even then, in the end, when I guess she got with Adam Driver or whatever, like, that didn't really need to happen.
No, it didn't need to happen.
And it didn't add anything to it, in my opinion.
They could have cut down the whole, like, pageant thing.
The pageant thing, I think, did pay off. But I feel like it would have paid off more.
That was cute.
It would have paid off more if his daughter was in the movie more. Do you guys remember the motivation for even doing the heist?
Because he lost his job.
Yeah, he had money.
Because he lost his job and he was going to hire a lawyer and he was going to try to get his daughter he was going to try to get at least some form of custody, I'm assuming. But instead, he just moved down there and took his days.
I mean, I don't know if he ever, like, stressed that this was, like, for, like, getting his daughter, like, getting custody of his daughter or whatever. Like, the lawyer line.
But, I mean, what did he do it for, then?
I guess just to have money.
But why didn't he just get, he got another job at Lowe's.
Yeah, but, I mean, a job at Lowe's is not, like, the same amount of money as, like, robbing
the
place.
I think the point kind of got lost on the fact that they just wanted to show a cool heist in it.
Yeah. I don't know. Yeah. I don't think the motivation
was
doing the heist
wasn't very strong.
That great. Yeah, I don't know. Like, there's just a couple things that, like, I feel like it meandered on too long. Mm-hmm. Motivation wasn't that great. There's way too many characters.
Yeah.
You didn't spend enough time with characters that were stronger than the ones that you did spend time
Hillary Swank. Like, cut down, tightened up, you know, focused.
It just, like, to me, it was... First of all, I went into this movie knowing literally nothing about it.
Cool.
And what I took away from it was just a good watch. You know what I mean? It's not setting the world on fire. Not everything's a masterpiece, as we've said. It's not a 10 out of 10. It's not
going
to set the world on fire. But it is a very enjoyable movie to watch, and it's very tight.
I mean, without the dialogue being as good as it was, I don't think that I would have anything positive to say.
And without the actors... Yeah.
Without the great cast.
Yeah.
But I think that the dialogue was so good and, like, you know, all the actors did such a great job that I don't really care. But there are a couple things where it's, like, missed opportunities. Mm. I feel like they could have totally ended this thing with an even bigger bang by having Seth MacFarlane's character be, like, the one they framed. Because I thought that's the direction they were going in. And I was like, this is great. I was like, oh my God.
You that's what I thought that it was.
Framed this asshole, right?
Yeah, when she was talking to him or whatever. Yeah.
And it would have added on to the joke of this guy just keeps getting fucking abused.
By those two, yeah.
Yeah, just by those two. Yeah, and I would have loved that. But even then, like, nothing happened there.
Yeah, I wasn't sure how I felt about Seth MacFarlane's character, to be honest.
I thought he was, like, funny because he wasn't in it that much.
Well, that's true. If he was in it a lot, I'd probably kill myself.
But. Yeah, like I was saying.
His whole point was being really fucking obnoxious.
Yeah, he was a really annoying character. But I wasn't sure, like, when he first popped up, I was like, oh, boy. Like, I was like, I because he was listed, you know, like, on the...
He was third billed.
Like, he was, like, third up. And I was just like, you know, I saw that poster before and whatever, and I was expecting him to be...
Like a major character.
In it quite a bit. So when I saw him pop in like that, I was like, oh, Jesus.
I almost feel like a little bit that Steven Soderbergh was trying too hard to be Steven Soderbergh by having as many characters as they had in this movie. Mm. When really, in reality, I don't think he needed all that. And it just kind of bloated the whole thing.
Yeah, I would agree with that.
And especially since those FBI scenes amounted to nothing. They didn't even catch anybody. That's why I was saying the FBI scenes would have been more meaningful if they had framed Seth MacFarlane's character. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then Seth MacFarlane's character also would have been more meaningful. But instead, the FBI thing just
went
nowhere.
It was just like, yeah, we're done.
Yeah, it literally went nowhere.
Yeah, and then nothing even happened with the fact that the racetrack was clearly, you know, doing something shady.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So they were just like,
yeah,
whatever. And when she showed up at the bar at the end, I was like, she's gonna fucking get these guys, isn't she?
That's what I thought too.
Nope.
It sends.
I was like, what the fuck happened? I was like, what is this?
Shot of his arm holding the. I thought it was really funny though. It was like when we first see. Was Clyde, right?
Yeah.
At the bar, post everything, and he's the new arm, and it's like this like really fancy arm, and he's like the robotic like hands.
Yeah,
no, it's good. Man,
I think they just wanted to keep building on the Adam Driver joke. And
I mean, like, thing about this movie is that it's so funny and it's so well acted and everything and well written that it doesn't really matter that there were so many like. Kind of bloated plot lines, right? Yeah. I didn't feel like any of the secondary storylines were nearly as strong as the primary in this case. But they were all funny still.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. No, and I agree with Tyler. I think it was definitely an enjoyable watch. Definitely something that people should see. At least once,
There's a video right there, and then there's a subscribe button right here, which you must smash in order to pass. Thank you.